Well, in this section, we'll learn the basics of a shopping app or a shopping cart. Before we go ahead and learn this section, first take a look what we have covered previously. Well, previously we learned our app architecture and we learned that from main method, we'll call init method and then we'll load the dependencies. And in general, our dependencies are API client, repositories and controllers. And that's how the whole app comes alive and it runs, okay? And based on that, later on, we learned how to build nested JSON, how to work with nested JSON, how to encode and decode nested JSON. And we also learned how to build product model. Now, we'll go ahead and take a look at the basics of a shopping cart or shopping app, okay? So in general, we'll have UI, and UI would interact with the product controller, and the product controller would interact with cart controller, and the cart controller would interact with local storage. How the interaction happens? Here it goes. So in your UI, you will have an instance of your product. So we'll have a product instance. And using that product instance, using a dot operator, we'll call the properties, fields, and methods from our product controller. Now, if you need more information from a cart controller, so you can have an instance of cart controller inside product controller. Thus, you'd be able to call the information from cart controller inside product controller, okay? And then UI would get instance as well from cart controller or the properties, but not directly. It will happen through product controller, okay? For example, product controller from here, the instance would call cart controller. From here, we'll call some fields or properties of product controller, and then product controller will go ahead and call the related fields methods of cart controller using an instance of cart controller inside the product controller. Now, the same will happen for local storage from cart controller. Well, the cart controller will have an instance of local storage. So if I'm going to get some information from local storage, I will get inside cart controller using the local storage instance, okay? So that's how the basic flow works. So in general, for a shopping app, you wouldn't really go ahead and call the methods or fields of cart controller directly inside UI. You do it through product controller, okay? And if product controller wants to get some information from local storage, it won't directly interact with the local storage. It would happen through cart controller. And this way, our logics are all separated, business logics, and your code becomes cleaner. Now, after learning this, we'll go ahead and build our shopping cart.